Now it's time for On the Money. Today we're talking about a major purchase, buying a car. Experts from 1-to-1 Financial Credit Union are joining us to discuss the current financial topics and ways to save your family money. Here's from 1-to-1 Financial, Lisa Harris, the director of lending. So should you set a budget before you start looking at vehicles?
Absolutely. You need to know exactly, what is your budget, but also within that budget, also consider whether the insurance, the gas, and the maintenance as well.
Well, and when you buy a vehicle, it's not just, there's an out-the-door price and then there's a not-out-the-door price. You know what I mean? So you may look at a price and you're like, oh, I can afford that. But then when they add up the taxes and fees, that adds to it. So really, you should probably look maybe a little less than what you can max out at. Is that what you
said? Yes, that would be smart. Simply because, when you're dealing with, tax title in the state of Florida, each county has different taxes and fees that goes along with that as well.
And another piece of advice, maybe know what vehicle you want, or can you just kind of set your budget and go? Should you have more of an idea, or what do you think?
Well, I would say, pick the vehicle you want, because a lot of people kind of get into trouble trading year after year. Because you'll be dealing with a lot of negative equity. So know
that it's better to just pick a car and stick with it for a while.
Yes, because it really takes you about 3 years into a five-year finance to break even.
Yeah, man. What about financing? What are some options with that?
Financing is always better to check with your personal banker. We offer at the credit union, classes and different programs to be able to help our members be smarter and wiser when they go out to purchase an automobile. Know your credit score. Do your homework online. Make sure that you do know where you are, where your budget is, and you kind of go from there.
And a credit union a lot of time does have the lower interest rates as well, is what
yes.
I found.
Yes.
So a great way to go about that. And then how do you know what you're really paying when you're making this purchase?
Buying a car can be a Pandora's box. When you're dealing with new or used, whether you're going to have rebates or whether you're going to, have other incentives that are going there. That's a Pandora's box.
Yeah, just expect the unexpected.
Yes.
Now, how do you negotiate? I feel like that's the hardest part for people, because people who don't like confrontation or being a little aggressive may not be good at that.
I would say set a price. Mm-hmm. Before you go to the dealership, you find the particular car you want, whether it's a sedan, a sports car, a truck, SUV. Go online, do your homework, figure out exactly the price range in which you want to stay based upon your budget. And you go in and you see the value of the vehicle. Yeah, whether that's new, where you have rebates offered on that, or whether it's used, what year it is, what's the term that you'll be able to carry on this particular unit. So,
and money talks, right? I mean, if you come in and say, hey, I've got a cash deposit, obviously have to finance the rest, can that kind of be a way to negotiate as well instead of just doing a trade-in?
Yes. And knowing the value of your trade-in is important as well, because it's all in your trade value. And also that's going to dictate your taxes as well.
Is there a certain time that maybe it's better for a consumer to buy a vehicle?
In my experience, in which I've been on the retail side as well, is that the best time to buy is the last day of the month. It's not about the volume. I mean, it's not about the profit. It's about the volume.
Okay, good to know. All right, last day of the month, head out there and get yourself a car.
That's right.
Thank you so much. And for more on how to join 1-to-1 Financial Credit Union, questions for the show, applying for a loan, you can visit www.121fcu.org, or you can email the email listed there on your screen or give them a call. The phone number is listed there as well, 904-723-6300. Thank you.